Hey guys, it's Evelyn. Welcome back to my channel. It's nice to see you guys. It's been forever since I filmed a video, and I literally just checked because this is my second time filming this intro, but it's been 4 months since I filmed my last video, and honestly, I've just been super unmotivated to film, and a lot of my friends have been asking me why I haven't filmed, and I honestly just said I don't know, but hopefully after this video I will be back. I really enjoyed filming them and like editing my videos, like when I would actually do it, but I took half of those videos off my channel because they're a little rough. Hopefully after this I actually like my videos and like I'm proud of them, you know? So in today's video I'm just going to be doing a get ready with me, as you can tell by the title. And I love watching these videos. I watch them probably like 90% of the time on YouTube. And they're just fun to watch people get ready, and like I sometimes watch these while I get ready. So yeah, and I'm not really gonna like talk through a lot of it. I'm just gonna get ready just like that because it's gonna take a while. And I'm kinda running late already, so yeah, I have a party to go to later, so I was like, why not film me getting ready? That's what I'm doing, and let's get started. I have my hair up because I hate when people get ready and their hair is like in their face. Like, come on now. I already washed my face because if I don't wash my face, I feel like my foundation and like concealer look really off. I don't know if it's just me, but I used to actually not wash my face. That's why I had so much acne. I like using these little things. They're so cute. Like, look. I look so cute. And I don't know if you guys have been with me for a while on my channel, but you guys, if you guys remember, I suffered with terrible acne, and it went away, but I have one pimple right here, which has not gone away. So the first thing I start off with is moisturizer. And I do this because my face is kind of dry after washing my face, so I just like to moisturize it. And it smells really good too, so that's the first step. After that, I take my Baby Skin Instant Pore Eraser, and a lot of the things I've used have not changed, and that's because my mom texted me. Okay, got distracted there. But a lot of the things I've used haven't changed much because honestly, like, they work perfectly fine for me, and like they don't break me out or anything, which is like a really good thing. And so like I'm not really the type to go and buy makeup anymore. Like if I run out of something, like I'll go rebuy it, but I won't look for like a complete new product, just because I feel like before, like when I wasn't even good at makeup, like not that I am now, but like when I wasn't as good, I would always want to buy makeup, and like now, like I don't even care to buy makeup anymore. Now that that is done, I start with my eyebrows, and I'm still using the Dip Brow, and I literally use the same products as I said. Okay, I got it open. So first thing is I just take my spoolie and then just comb out my eyebrows. I'm gonna speed through this because I literally don't do anything. All I do is just fill in my eyebrow and then carve it out with concealer at the end. But I'll cut to that once I'm done filling in my eyebrow. Now that I did my eyebrows, they used to take me such a long time for me to do, especially because like I used to carve them out first in order to get the shape, but that's when I didn't get my eyebrows done. But now that I get them done, it's so much easier to just fill them in and then carve them out. But next I'm using Tarte Shape Tape. This freaking concealer is amazing. Right now I'm just going to put a little bit of concealer on my brush and then just do the bottom. And then on the top, I just do that with my foundation, but that's after. So I'm gonna speed this up because this part's kind of boring. Alrighty, now that my eyebrows are almost like 90% done, I move on to eyeshadow, and I just put a little bit of the same, concealer, and I use it as like a base for my eyeshadow just because it's already on my eyebrows, so I just use this. So for eyeshadow, I usually just lean towards one of these two, and actually I've been using, which one have I been using the most? So I think I'm gonna go with the 35O from Morphe, and today I'm actually not going to be wearing foundation. I'm not going to be wearing eyelashes today just because I feel like there's just days where you know you wanna wear eyelashes, and then times where you don't. So today I'm not going to because I'm not feeling it today. But yeah, I'm gonna just do like a simple eyeshadow, literally probably just like two colors, and then I'm gonna be done. I'm first going to be taking the Luxie 205 tapered blending brush, and this is honestly my favorite. If I had to pick one eyeshadow brush, it'd be this one. Color that's same color as my skin tone, and then just putting that in my crease. And I'm gonna do it to the other side also. Now that I have that color in, I'm taking another brush. This is the Morphe R35. But next, I'm gonna take a little bit of a peachier shade. Maybe. I forgot Morphe things don't say names. I like how the Jaclyn Hill one says a name on the back, but this one does not. It's just a little bit darker than the first one, and then I'm gonna focus that towards the bottom, and then taking the first brush I used, the Luxie Taper 205, I think. Yeah, I'm just gonna make sure and blend everything all together. Using another Morphe MB44, I'm taking a darker brown because I want my eyeshadow to be a little bit dark today. Right here, can you see? Packing it in there, and then I'm gonna blend it out after. Then I'm gonna just take a little bit of this goldish type of glitter so it can balance out the colors. Now that we're done with the eyeshadow, I move on to my face now. Taking the Tarte Shape Tape in light neutral, and then I'm going to put some on my face. What to do is speed this up because I'm just gonna blend it in, but I'm using just a mini sponge to blend this all into my face. Once my concealer is done, like, it doesn't cover like 100% of what I want to cover, but I have a foundation for that, and I'm still using the Kat Von D Locket foundation, and I'm still in the shade light 48. I use the Real Techniques Expert Face Brush, and I love this one also. I haven't stopped using it, and basically what I do is I just put it on my finger, and then on either of my fingers, and then I just like kind of like tap it a little bit, and then I just place it on my face and do one at a time because this one kind of dries fast and it oxidizes a little bit, so that's why I work in sections on my face. So I'm going to do that right now.
waking up, starlight, take me there. Yeah, I wanna fly. So as I was doing the foundation on my forehead, I realized I didn't conceal the top, so I'm gonna do that now, which it doesn't really matter honestly because I'm using the same product and the same shade on my forehead, so if it looks off, I can just blend it out and it'll be fine. And I'm not gonna record this just because there's no point, but now that that part is done, I can blend it out in case there's like a super white spot. But for the most part, I think my face is done. Then I'm just going to take the Benefit Gimme Brow. Use this for a long time. And it's just so my eyebrows won't go crazy. Actually use bronzer because I'm still not that good at it, and then I don't want to mess up when I'm pretty much almost done. But now I'm using the Milani Tea Rose blush. It's really, really nice. I really like the color. It's not like super pink and it's not like really orangey or tan. It's like the perfect shade for me. So lastly, one of the last few steps is mascara. So I'm just going to curl my eyelashes. And it takes me a while to curl them because I want to make sure they're all curly and stuff. So I'm going to get back to you guys once I finish. Alrighty, now that I curled my eyelashes, eyelashes is honestly my favorite thing, like, ever for makeup. Like, I just love the look of eyelashes that are, like, really full and bold. So as you guys can see, this eye is a lot more full than this one, and it's really black, so it's kind of hard when you have eyeshadow on already because I hate having to like take it off. I'm going to do this to the other eye, and then hopefully they turn out the same. Then I take my Morphe palette again, and then I think it's called a pencil brush, I'm not sure, but kind of looks like a pencil. I don't know if you guys can see that. And then I take one of the colors I used and then I put it on my bottom lash line. Lastly, I'm just going to put a little bit of a highlighter color. And then I'm not going to put on lipstick quite yet. I'm just going to put on chapstick because I'm still probably going to eat. And I still have to brush my teeth after because I've been eating pretty much it. And then to set my entire face, I use the Morphe Continuous Setting Spray. I'm probably going to spray some right now just so I have it can hold for a while. So that felt so refreshing. And then it just melts everything together also, which is really nice. So I think I'm done, and now I don't look that bad anymore. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. I'm not sure if all of you guys found this interesting. Hope you guys learned something. I don't know. I don't know who watches my videos anymore because the part that I died, but now I'm back. What else to say? I can't say to subscribe already because I just came back, so you guys can subscribe in my next video or something. But yeah, I'm gonna go continue getting ready. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!